I'm Bruce Bugbee, president of Apogee Instruments, and today I'd like to talk about chlorophyll meters, especially the non-destructive chlorophyll meters that are very widely used by a number of people. We'll go through a little bit of the history of it, how they work, and then the advances that have been made over the years. So in the 1980s, Minolta came out with this meter. It was made by the Scientific Products Analysis Division at Minolta, and they call it, use their acronym, call it a SPAD meter. Sometimes people have begun to think SPAD is synonymous with chlorophyll, and it is not. It's an acronym for a company. But that was the first meter. Then some years later, Optisciences came out with this meter. It has some advantages over the Minolta meter, a little bigger area to average leaves. And then recently, Apogee Instruments came out with this meter, which has some fundamental advances over the other types of research-grade meters for chlorophyll. So let's take a look at what those differences are. The first thing is, if we draw a leaf, it's full of cells. And these cells are full of chlorophyll. If we shine a light on this leaf and we put a detector down here, we can get the transmitted light through the leaf. This is pretty easy to do, and it gets us the amount of cellulose in the leaf and the amount of chlorophyll in the leaf, both together. The chlorophyll is in here in little packets inside these cells. So to really be able to measure this, we take another wavelength of light and another detector down here. And this is red light, and this is near infrared light, NIR. These are all on the Apogee website, the details of these. And now by subtraction, we can get at the amount of chlorophyll in this leaf. And it's the electrical output of these two detectors. When we make a graph of this difference and we put transmission down here, the ratio of these wavelengths, and we put chlorophyll up here, and I'm going to abbreviate that just CHL for chlorophyll. This would be lovely if we got a nice straight line and the transmission was directly related to chlorophyll. We would have a meter that told us chlorophyll. Unfortunately, the distribution of chlorophyll in a leaf is so clumped up that the light goes in many directions, it doesn't come straight through the leaf, and when we make this graph, it's highly nonlinear. That's a fundamental characteristic of all of these optical meters, to get this nonlinear relationship between transmission and chlorophyll. So here, let me show you what happens with this. If we put tick marks in this graph now, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We make a measurement here, and we have that much chlorophyll. Let's call that amount 1. Now we make another measurement out here at 5, and you would think the chlorophyll went up by a factor of 2.5, and in fact, it doesn't. This only doubles. So the transmission is not a direct indicator of the chlorophyll in the leaf. This has led to lots of problems. People write papers and they say the SPAD number went from 2 to 4, therefore my chlorophyll doubled. And that is wrong. The chlorophyll did not double. This index doubled. So the SPAD Minolta meter that reads in SPAD units only gives an index that's non-linearly related to chlorophyll. The Optisciences meter also gives an index that's non-linearly related to chlorophyll. Because of these problems, and because of the need to really measure chlorophyll, Apogee Instruments built on the research that developed characteristic lines like this for each species of plant. There's one line for wheat, there's another line for corn, there's a line for rice. They all take the same basic shape, they just have slightly different curvatures. With this equation, you can convert transmission into actual chlorophyll in the leaf, and the result is a graph where we have chlorophyll here, actual chlorophyll measured by extracting the chlorophyll, and this unit down here is now optical chlorophyll, or optical CHL, and the relationship is a straight line. So we can very accurately measure chlorophyll in the leaf with the appropriate software in the meter to convert these curved, this family of curved lines into straight lines. That's the beauty of the Apogee meter in terms of what it does to get chlorophyll. This took a lot of work, a lot of measurements of chlorophyll and non-destructive chlorophyll. We have a video that shows the techniques to do that. There's a family of curves in there for 22 species, and it's growing. We're getting a curve in there for potatoes and other species now, so we can establish this linear relationship between what the optical meter measures and the true chlorophyll in the leaf. So, in a nutshell, that's the advance in this. And it's a sufficiently big advance that Apogee patented this meter. It has a patent pending on this meter. It now allows researchers to get measurements of chlorophyll without having to kill the leaf, without having to extract the leaf and measure it in a spectrophotometer. So, thanks for listening. That's a nutshell of the advances in these measurements over the last 30 years.